morning, dear students. So, as you know, we are continuing chapter number 14, that is natural resources. So, out of this natural resources, today we are going to discuss about a very important natural resource called water. Okay, so let's start. See, dear children, in our complete earth, we know that 1/3 portion is water. Okay? So 75% is covered by water only. So here the water area which is covered on earth, out of that ocean is 97.5%. This is about the distribution of water. Okay, so ocean is covering 97.5% and 2.5% which is left, it is fresh water. Okay, and out of this 2.5% which is fresh water, 70% water is frozen water, 30% water is ground water, and lake and river is covering 0.3% of water. Okay, we know that ocean water is salty and it is not usable for us. Okay, so we all are dependent on fresh water. So that's why you must be thinking that, oh, on earth so much of water is there, then also it is said that save water, save water, save water everywhere. So why? Because out of that 97.5% is of no use for us, and the water which is usable, out of that also it is distributed in this way. So we have to save each and every drop of water for our future security. Okay, so this is about distribution of water. Now my question is, why do we need water? You know, in our daily life we do lots of work which is impossible without water. If you take the working of a human body or the working of a living thing only, in that only you can understand that how important water is. See, why do we need water? We need water for cellular processes. Okay, the cells which are present in our body, for their functioning, for their fulfillment of their requirement and for various need, water is needed. Okay, the millions of cells which are present in our body, all that cells need water for their metabolic processes. Then chemical reactions means inside our body many chemical reactions are taking place to form new substances. So for all that chemical reaction, again water is required. Then again water is required, as you know, inside your body there is a transportation system, and by the transportation system your oxygen, food, waste material, everything moves from one organ to the other organ. Okay, so that transportation system also need water. So you can imagine that without water our complete life is impossible. Then for our day-to-day purposes, like for irrigation purpose, then sewage disposal, then washing utensils, washing clothes, all these things require water. Okay, then terrestrial life forms. Okay, so terrestrial life forms mean like trees are there, then animals are there, then plants are there, then we human beings are there. We all are living on the land. Land is covering the terrestrial region. Okay, so all the terrestrial life forms, they need water. And you know the aquatic life also, which are very important, they also can live only in water. Okay, so water is very very essential and important for us. Now another thing, like if we are talking about ocean water, sea water, which is intolerant for us, it is salty, we cannot use that water. Okay, so we have to we have to save this much of water with proper use. Now let us discuss little bit about availability of water. If water is available on earth, then water decides. The availability of water is deciding the number of individual of each species in a particular area. Yes, the availability of water is deciding the number of individual present in a particular area. Okay, so how it is doing it? See, as we know that water is essential for our life, and with the places where water is present, that place only will be suitable for the life forms to live. Okay, the different type of life forms to live. Right, availability of water. Along with the availability of water, we also need soil. We also need soil and the proper atmosphere. Okay, soil and proper temperature. So water, soil and temperature, these are the list of things which decides the number of individual present in that area. If proper temperature is there, if the soil quality is good, where farming is possible, then if water availability is good. So these are the things, these are the points which will decide that yes, what will be the diversity in the life forms in that particular area. If all these things will be in good amount and in proper amount, then the life form will be more and more, and the life forms, there will be a diversity in life form and it will be more in that particular area. Okay, so availability of water decides the number of individual living in that particular area. Then come to water pollution. Let us discuss about water pollution. Now, what is the meaning of water pollution? How can we define water pollution? What is water pollution? See, pollution means the presence of something unwanted or undesirable in water, air and soil. Okay, so the presence of undesirable substances in water, air and soil makes water pollution, soil pollution and air pollution. Okay, now how is this happening? Let us discuss some of the sources that which are polluting the water. Okay, so what are that? See, some of the water pollutants we can see here. Some of the water pollutants. these are. And some radioactive substances are like battery, anti-freezing substances, and latex paint, these are again some of the pollutants. Okay. Now let us come to the first one, that is organic substances. Okay. Now water, which is we are saying that it is a natural resource and it is very very important for our life. So this water is polluted by nobody else. That is only us. Okay. We are the people who are polluting water. So what we are doing and how we are polluting water? See, first we are adding some of the organic substances, some inorganic substances, then some radioactive substances and some biological substances. By adding these substances, water is getting polluted. Okay? Like organic substances, if we talk, so it comes to pesticides, fertilizers and detergents. So what are these fertilizers, pesticides and detergents? See, detergent means every day what we are doing, we are washing our clothes and we are washing utensils. All that water is going and mixing in water reservoirs, big reservoirs. Okay? And you have seen that in villages, people they take their clothes and wash near to the river, and then all that detergent water it gets mixed with big water reservoir. Okay, which makes the life of which makes aquatic life very dangerous. And then if you talk about fertilizers, so what are fertilizers? Fertilizers means farmer, they add fertilizers for the better and good growth of their crops. So when we are adding all these fertilizers to the plant, then what is happening? These fertilizers are remaining in that plant and some of the fertilizers just fall down and it gets mixed in the soil. So when rain comes, so with the rain water, these fertilizers get mixed in soil and then it flows and get mixed in big reservoirs. Again, then it disturbs the life of the animals and animals which are living in water. Then pesticides are itself, these are the poisons which the farmer they give to the plant so that all these insects and pests they get killed. So here what is happening, we are only adding the poisonous thing, and when rain comes, it gets mixed with the rain and then goes inside the soil, and through the soil it mixes in the big reservoirs. So by these, all these things are adding poisonous things to the water, big water reservoir, and just depleting it. And then if we talk about inorganic substances, like nitrogen, nickel, lead, mercury, these are the things which are coming out from the factories and industries, and then all that waste are disposed in water reservoirs. Okay. Then radioactive substances, like atomic bomb, if some batteries are they are of no use, and in big factories and industries also these batteries and anti-freezing substances are there. And then latex paint, all these things are there. So these chemical things are also added to the water, and then they make a complete layer which is very very harmful. These paints and all, they make a complete layer which do not allow oxygen to pass, and these things are very harmful. And then animals, they are completely hampered by all these things. Okay. And if you talk about biological substances, in biological substances the viruses, bacteria, trichomonas, all these things are coming which get mixed in water and then they pollute water. Okay. So these are some water pollutants. So these are some water pollutants, and you also think about some of the water pollutants which pollute the water by any means and make a list of. Okay. So this is about water.